Okay, students, are you able to see the PPT? Yes,
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so in last lecture we have seen the formation of P and N type materials. Now we will see here PN junction. So suppose this is the material and here this is the junction and this side we have P type material and this side we have N type material. So already we know that in N type material what we have one free electron. And with the free electron, we have associated with one positive ion, right? In last lecture, we discussed this. One free electron is there, then associated positive ion is there, right? What is this positive ion? This is the impurity atom which you have added and which has donated this electron. And due to the donation of the electron, it has become now positive charge. So these are the ions. They are immovable. They don't move, right? They don't move because their weight is heavy as compared to electrons. So in this way, this type structure we are having in the N side. Right now, apart from these free electrons and positive ion, anything else is there? Yeah, some students should tell me something else is there. Apart from
holes,
these,
sir.
Holes. Holes and
free electrons.
Yeah, due to that thermal energy, there you will find free electron associated with the holes. Hole I am drawing with this circle, right? Like this. Holes are there, but they are less in number. They are less in number, right? In this way. Now, if you come to the P type, then what you will have? You will have holes and with the holes
also with the
negative ions.
Negative ions.
So what is this negative ion? What is this negative ion? Negative ion, because see, in the trivalent impurity, three electrons were there in the outermost orbit. Now one electron from the silicon has come to that fourth place. So one electron will come to the fourth place. So your impurity atom will become negative ion. Okay. And since one electron has come from the silicon after breaking of the covalent bond, so at that place you will find hole. So in this way you will find hole and associated with negative ion. This negative ion is your impurity atom. And it is heavy, right? It is heavy and it is immovable. It does not move. So in this way we have this combination, right? Holes are positive charge and negative ions are there. Negative ions are immovable. Okay, apart from this positive charged hole and negative ion, anything else is there? Yeah, apart from these holes and negative ion, anything else? Yes, due to the thermal energy, there is the breaking of the covalent bonds. So due to that breaking, you will find free electron and hole pair. So you will find free electron and hole. Free electron and hole. Free electron and hole, right? But the numbers are less. Now you see in n-type material, in n-type, int n-type, I am talking about the charge carrier. Charge carrier are those which can move. So we are having majority charge carriers. Majority charge. Are your electrons. Right, and minority charge are your holes. Right, you can see here in the n-type material there are three holes. I am showing three holes, so they are minority carriers. Now, if you see the p-type material, then in p-type material, if we talk about the majority carriers, majority charge are holes and minority. Charge carriers are your electrons. So see the p-type material, you will find holes are there in large number and three electrons I have shown here. So electrons are in minority. Okay. Now there is a term called as diffusion. What do you mean by diffusion? Can anyone tell? See, in diffusion, what will happen? Diffusion takes place due to one concept called as concentration gradient. Concentration gradient. Right. So what is concentration gradient? The difference in the concentration is called as concentration gradient. Okay. So in diffusion, what will happen? The things will move from high concentration to low concentration. Already we know that suppose there is a tank where water is full and there is a small tank attached where water is less. So what will happen? Water will flow from higher tank to lower tank, right? So here now you see, you just see n-type material. In n-type material, majority of the charge carriers are electrons. But if you see the p-type material, so you p-type material, you can find there are electrons, but electrons are very less in number, right? Due to minority carrier. So there is a concentration difference of the electrons in the p-type and n-type. In p-type, in n-type, concentration of electrons are more and concentration of electrons are less in p-type. So there is a concentration gradient. So electrons will tend to move, will try to move from p-type to, sorry, from n-type to p-type. We have not connected any battery here, any voltage, potential difference. Even then, due to the variation in the concentration, electrons will start moving from n-type to p-type. Okay, and holes are in majority carrier in p-type, and in n-type they are in very less in number. So holes will try to move from p-type to n-type, right? So due to diffusion or concentration gradient, what happened? Electrons move from n-type to p-type, and holes move from p-type to n-type, right? So in this, what will happen? You just concentrate here. I am talking about this electron, right? And this hole. So hole will try to move this side and electron will try to move this side, right? So what will happen when the electron will see any hole, then it will recombine with the hole, right? And electron and hole both will disappear, right? Because you see, if suppose there is some covalent bond is there. Suppose here there is one electron and there is a hole is here. So what will happen if some electron will come to this place? Then what will happen? Free electron will become valence electron, right? It will become valence electron and this hole will also disappear. So same thing will happen here. Same thing will happen here. This hole and this electron will recombine. Same way, this electron will recombine with this hole. This electron will recombine with this hole. Okay. Now you see, I am talking about now this electron. This electron will try to move towards this side, right? But now here in the P side, you find this. This is a negative charge, right? This is the negative charge, immobile negative ion. This is a negative charge. So what it will do? It will repel the electron. It will not allow the electron to move, right? Because both negative charge of the electron and negative charge of the ion will repel each other. So this electron will not able to pass through this. And same way, this hole from P side, it cannot move towards N side, because in the N side now we have this positive ion, right? So the further movement of electron and holes will be stopped after some time. Okay, after some time it will stop. Now once it will stop, then now you will find that now this region and this region. Now in this region, is there any charge carrier is there in this region? You just tell me. In this region, is there any charge carrier? Any student can tell me?
No, sir.
Yes, charge is there, but charge carrier is not there, right? You can find a positive charge and negative charge is there, but they are due to the ions, and ions are heavy, so they cannot move, so they are not carrier. So now in this region, there is no charge carrier right now. And this region is called as, can you tell me the name of this region?
Depletion region.
It has two names. One is space charge region. Space charge. Region. Okay. Or another name to this is depletion.
Depletion region.
Okay. What is the meaning of depletion? What is the meaning of depletion?
There is no charge carrier.
Oh, that is okay. No charge carrier, but meaning of depletion. Depletion. Depletion means you can say, if suppose there is water in a tank, right? And if all the water has been removed, then it is called as depletion of the water. Water has been removed. So now there is no water. So depletion means removal of the things, whatever is there.
Okay. Removal yeah. of holes and negative charges.
Yeah, removal of charge carriers.
Charge carriers.
Depletion means less in number. It is called as less. If the number of something is decreased, then it is called as depletion. Okay. So due to the decrement in the charge carriers in this region is called as depletion region. Okay. Right. So now this is the means when you join one p-type and n-type material, then initially there is the flow of the charge, right? Flow of the electrons from n-type to p-type. Flow of the holes from p type to n type due to the diffusion process, right? And due to this process, what will happen? Electrons and holes will recombine with each other and they disappear, right? So after some time, this movement diffusion will stop, right? This diffusion will stop because sufficient amount of positive and negative charge has been developed in P and N region to stop this movement, right? So now see the important thing. P type material is having this N type charge in this place, and N type material it is having in this depletion region positive charge, right? So a potential difference has been created in the p-n junction, where the positive charge of that potential difference is at the n region and the negative charge of that potential is at the p region. And can you tell me how much is this potential? How much is this potential developed in p-n junction? It depends upon the material. If the material is of germanium, if the material is
0.7 mil.
0.7. 0.3 volts. Yes. And in case of silicon.
Silicon 0.7.
Yes, correct. In case of silicon, it is
0.7 volts.
7. So this much potential will be developed if we have germanium or silicon type of material, right? So what is the phenomena of the formation of this potential? Already we discussed, and this potential is called as here this potential is called as potential barrier. This is called as potential barrier. Why it is called as potential barrier? Now you can tell me.
Because it has voltage,
it has a potential which acts as a barrier, which acts as a barrier for the further movement of the electrons and the holes, right? Because this is only the barrier, na, which stops the movement of further electrons and the hole. Because this barrier, due to this barrier only, the electrons from the N side is unable to move towards the P side. And holes from the P side are unable to move towards the N side, right? Due to this barrier only. So this potential barrier has been created now, right? Okay. So now when you will see the forward and reverse biasing. So first, this potential barrier has to be removed. Then only there will be the flow of the current. Then only there will be the flow of the current.
Also mute. In harness, you will keep.